The restoration of democracy in the Philippines after February 1986 took place with a firm conviction that the parliament of the streets and empowered communities are potent forces in the transformation of society. This conviction is embedded in the 1987 Constitution in its call for the establishment and strengthening of non-government and people's organizations.
The seeds of a foundation of a Philippine environment was actually first planted, first sown, when Cory won as president. She won because of people power. And when she came into her office, she was very clear that it was not traditional politics that propelled her to victory, and that it was a reflection on the thinking of the Filipino people at that time and the political situation, that perhaps it was time to phase out political parties as the sole force of Philippine political situation. And si sabi niya, since it was people power, we really have to give more power to the people so that this sort of historical development will continue. So when Cory gave that instruction, I was thinking of non-governmental organizations. We wanted an endowment fund that could be used by Philippine NGOs to help out Philippine NGOs without government participation.
The seed of FPE was planted in the soil of a newly recaptured democracy. The idea that became FPE grew out of a concern not only to assist local environmental action, but more to strengthen democracy itself through able and independent non-government and people's organizations. The hands that planted and nurtured the FPE seed are many, but they can be clustered into four major sectors: Philippine NGOs, the Philippine government, U.S. and U.S.-based NGOs, and the U.S. government. In November 1989, leaders of 10 environment and development NGOs, headed by Juni Calau of Haribon, traveled to the U.S. to lobby for substantial U.S. government support of NGOPO environmental work in the Philippines. Dubbed the NGO Mission on Environmental Policy, it was planned to coincide with the Philippine government mission to the U.S. Convinced that the NGO leaders' vision of having an independent Philippine donor NGO that would fund environmental efforts of NGOs and POs was worthwhile, Ford Foundation and the American Jewish Worldwide Services threw their support to the project.
That was a very difficult time because AID does not give to non-governmental organizations. It was purely government. AID, U.S. government to Philippine government, with the help of NGOs from the Philippines. Most notable sila Juni Calau, and meron nag-i-straddle si Celso Roque, NGO, nagsama-sama. Tapos sa Amerika, meron din Philippine Development Forum. Also concentrating at the time on environment. So they were working doon sa legislation doon to allow that. We're working here naman for AID to bring that together.
I was part of the group that went to the United States with Juni Calau, who was then in Green Forum and Haribon. I was part of the group that was representing PhilDRA and PhilSA. And we were a group of 8 people, if I'm not mistaken. And it was to really go and lobby that an endowment be given to the Philippines, Philippine NGOs that is, facilitated by government. We believe that one way of making sure that the aid money is sustained over a long period of time, as opposed to it comes, you spend, and it's gone, was to work for an endowment that's dedicated for sustainable development, environment defense, as we were calling it then, and ways to address poverty in these areas, because we really believe that poverty is one cause for the degradation, because people were being pushed up. And as they're pushed up, they begin to use the resources of the mountains in a way that will not be sustainable for nature and man.
The World Wildlife Fund was willing to help us out. Naisip nila yung debt for nature swap.
We had to look at the debts of the Philippines that were against the U.S. government or U.S. banks, okay? And had to convince the Philippine government and the U.S. government that instead of us paying the debt to them, that they, quote-unquote, forgive the debt and the money that would have been spent for payment would then be spent for the protection of the environment.
So the swap was made, and that swap was given as an endowment strictly for NGO work to be administered by NGOs. The only participation of government was there should always be one.
The lobbying efforts paid off. The U.S. Congress allocated funds for NGO environmental work with the provision that the fund would be handled by a U.S. NGO, WWF U.S. The Philippine side of the negotiations, however, preferred an entirely Filipino NGO to handle the fund. A solution was reached in 1991. A Philippine NGO acceptable to all parties would partner with WWF U.S. in the birthing of FPE. WWF would facilitate the debt swap and manage the fund in trust for FPE for 2 years, while the Philippine Business for Social Progress would oversee the creation of the FPE structure and provide the initial staff for its operations. The two organizations would nurture the FPE seed to make it grow. A priority matter that these two organizations focused on was the design of the governance structure of a donor NGO to be run by NGOs and POs, which also happened to be the beneficiaries of the grant funds of this donor NGO. With no local NGO to serve as a model, the interim FPE board, again with Ford assistance, visited U.S. foundations and philanthropic organizations to study their structures, policies, and processes. This was followed by consultations with over 300 NGOs and POs and 24 academic institutions throughout the country to solicit their views about how such an NGO should operate. Insights and lessons from these activities guided the development of the FPE governance structure.
PBSP was asked to design a process that would determine the governance structure of FPE. We were asked to do it because we had the credibility to engage the different sectors of the NGO community to that end. Regional consultations were made, and these consultations identified the different perspectives which have to be taken into consideration in forming the governance structure. From the very start, it was clear that the community wanted a geographical representation, a gender representation, a sectoral representation, and that even and even marginalized sectors are in fact established. When this was all put together, what emerged was an inclusive process which resulted into the representation of the different sectors in the governing board. This was important because I felt that since the board had access to resources and in fact would decide on allocation of resources, that the board's composition in fact represented the different perspectives and would put equity and balance in the allocation of resources.
FPE was registered as a non-stock, non-profit, non-government organization on January 15, 1992 with the Securities and Exchange Commission. The seed that was nurtured had broken ground and become a seedling. With an initial capital base of $21.8 million from a debt for nature swap, the debt swap proceeds, given in Philippine pesos, was set up as an endowment, thus enabling FPE to sustain its assistance to NGO and PO environment protection initiatives. After the debt swap was completed, the DENR, the USAID, and FPE entered into a joint memorandum of understanding creating the Environment Endowment to be managed by FPE. Signed in March 1993, the MOU stipulates the uses of the investment income of the fund. 1. Conservation of Philippine biological diversity, encompassing protected area management and development, ecological information base and survey, environmental education, and public awareness. 2. Technical skills and capability building and organizational and technical components of project proponents, comprising training and professional development, network development, and institutional support. And 3. Community-based resource management, including community organizing and extension, ecotourism, and green trade. Created as a manifestation of the country's commitment to the Convention on Biological Diversity, FPE is the largest grant-making institution outside of government to support biodiversity conservation and sustainable development work of NGOs and POs in the Philippines.
I am very pleased to represent the United States government at today's historic event. The turnover of endowment funds marks the real beginning of the Foundation for the Philippine Environment's role as a lead institution in support of environmentally sound development.
The management of the endowment was turned over from WWF US to FPE in June 1994. However, it took another 2 years of further establishing credibility and track record before FPE actually managed its own funds.
This event has been more than 2 years in the making, but rather than detract from the worth of the output, the length of time it took to come to this turnover is actually the basis of the strength of the final product.
FPE thus proceeded on its journey as an NGO environmental endowment fund managed by NGOs and POs for NGOs and POs. The seedling has become a sapling and taken out of the nursery.
We agreed that the money will be put in the bank and we will only use the interest from out of the funds that were given to use for projects. And the projects we agreed should be 80% of the funds for projects, 20% for administration. So as treasurer, I had to make sure then that the endowment was going into projects that would directly address the issues that we identified at that time. The issues that we identified was part of environment defense is to assure that the communities around or the communities benefiting or working in the threatened environment had sources of livelihood and an understanding of why it is to their benefit that they should keep the environment sustainable.
FPE's policymaking body is the 11-member Board of Trustees. It is composed of 6 NGOs, POs representatives, 2 each from Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao, 1 representative from an international environmental NGO, 3 members at large who can come from academe, business, church groups, indigenous peoples groups, or NGOs, and 1 representative from the Philippine government, from either the Department of Finance or the Central Bank. The board members are nominated by the members of the 3 regional advisory committees, or RACs, which are composed of 15 members each from Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao. The RACs also advise the board on matters related to policy, program development, and governance. For purposes of continuity, FPE maintains as permanent members all the former chairpersons of the Board of Trustees. Together with the incumbent trustees, these members elect the incoming board members. And several former BOD members are invited to become part of a policy advisory committee. FPE envisions itself as a dynamic, relevant, proactive, and growing organization, enabling civil society and other stakeholders towards effective biodiversity conservation and sustainable development. For its partners, envisions communities caring responsibly and living fully in harmony with their environment. As its mission, FPE aims to be a catalyst for biodiversity conservation and sustainable development of communities in critical sites. To undertake its mission, FPE assumes three roles. As a catalyst for cooperation, FPE encourages international and local cooperation between and among communities, NGOs and POs, business groups and government agencies towards developing policies and effective programs for biodiversity conservation and sustainable development. As a grant maker, FPE initiates, assists, and finances biological diversity conservation and sustainable development activities. As a fund facilitator, FPE generates additional financial resources for funding qualified projects in biodiversity conservation and sustainable development. The sapling has become a young tree, starting to bear fruits.
We do not only look at financial resources, we also look at the human resources that we have there in the community. And we recognize this as part of the resources that we facilitate around, you know, in addressing agendas and addressing issues and concerns of biodiversity conservation and sustainable development. So, but concretely, there are many levels of fund facilitation. One such level is working together with other donor institutions. A clear example of this was a program that was co-financed by the Foundation for the Philippine Environment and the MacArthur Foundation. And this program was called the Community Forestry Program. It's a four-year program that was 50% financed by FPE and 50% financed by the MacArthur Foundation. And we worked together in two communities, one in Samar and one in Cagayan Province, to help the communities there, manage sustainably their forest resources.
Now the tree is mature, able to withstand stormy weather. FPE now has three regional offices, one for Luzon, one for Visayas, and one for Mindanao. It is supporting conservation initiatives in environmentally critical sites all over the country. It has funded capability building, advocacy, research, environmental education, and environmental defense projects. It has co-financed projects with local and international donors. It has funded the publication of books, production of videos, and other communication materials. It has also facilitated the creation of another NGO funding mechanism for the environment and helped create issue-based coalitions of NGOs and POs. Through its various funding windows, the foundation has given out more than 560 million pesos in grants to small and large projects of around 500 NGOs and POs. As FPE journeyed with its partners and allies in conservation, it saw the need to have more effective forms of intervention. The foundation has therefore developed a national environmental agenda as the overarching framework for its strategies for 2005 to 2014. Within this agenda are the seven strategies that FPE has adopted to address environmental threats and support conservation initiatives. C. Constituency building. A. Advocacy. R. Research. R. Resource mobilization. E. Environmental defense. S. sites. I for institutional strengthening. FPE grants can be small, medium, or large. Small grants can amount to a maximum of 150,000 pesos. Medium grants up to 400,000 pesos. And large grants up to 2 million pesos. The FPE web contains its grant guidelines and forms to be used. The lessons learned and challenges faced by FPE and its partners showed that empowered communities can adopt measures to conserve biodiversity in their sites while sustaining their livelihoods.
Biodiversity is a key foundation for sustainable development. If we don't put biodiversity in the agenda, then all our work will be useless, no? Because many of our communities, no, from time immemorial until today, depend on biodiversity for their livelihood. And we survive. We have clean air, we have water, because of biodiversity.
All thanks to the NGOs. They are a very faithful partner in these development activities and initiatives.
When we began FPE, the dream was that those who would be the partners of FPE are going to be mainly or mostly people's organization, because we believe that part of the empowerment agenda is to ensure that it's really the people, the community, who are taking care of the environment in the place where they stay, and that this is really their investment to the future. So we really believe that people's organizations are important in being part of the implementation, and I'm so glad that what's going on now is that, you know, you have people's organization handling the money and being able to implement the program.
The foundation continues to subscribe to the saying that we do not really own this world. We are merely taking care of it for the next generation.
Walang madadapuan ang mandaragit, walang mapupugaran ang ibong pipit, walang maialay na dahot sanga ang gubat na namamatay na. Walang masisilungan ng hito at dalag, walang matataguan ang hipon at kasag. Sila ay lilipulin sa madalit malaon, walang patatawarin sa sabog at laso. Wala nung gagamasin ang manggagamas, wala rin gagapasin ang manggagapas ang dagat nating ikinabubuhay ay dagat na ikinamamatay.